Hi, this is James Whittaker here with the Cayman Compass. I'm here with Catherine Tyson, who is running as an independent in the district of Georgetown South in the May 2017 general election. Ms. Tyson, thank you for joining us. Just got a few questions to ask you. First of all, just tell us a bit about yourself and why you're running for the LA.
Well, I'm Catherine Tyson, as you've just heard, and I've decided to, as they call it, throw my hat in the ring for some different reasons. I think there's a part of me that knows that at this point in my life that I could do other things, like basically coast and just lay back, all right, great, life is good, let's see how everybody else does. But I think, you know, when I see what's happening in my country and I think about some of the things that I feel that I could contribute to changes, that kind of compels me really to put my hat in the ring and, stand up for the women, the families, and, you know, bring men back into the picture and just some heart things. I think I bring a lot of heart to this whole program, and I'm very interested in seeing that happen for our country.
And what do you think is the most important issue facing your district?
That's such an interesting question, James, because my district is split almost. I have, part of Windsor Park and I have South Sound area. So it's kind of very different issues that the realities of the residents and their lives. So where in Windsor Park might be experiencing this, South Sound might be experiencing something else. So it's taken a lot of thought, just this constituency situation that we're in with the one man, one vote, that I've had to give a lot of thought to that. But I think mostly what I'm looking at are the common things that I think connect us, and that's family, that's the ability to thrive in your own country, that's getting the best education for your children, that's the interest of community and the interest of building your countries for sustainability. I think that's across the board.
And what about the Cayman Islands as a whole? What's the most important single issue for the country, would you say?
I'm not sure if that is a question that I can answer, a single most important issue. I think there are so many issues right now. But I do think one of the major issues is that we feel as a people that our country is actually, working for us. And I think that's one of the things that I'm hearing in all the different areas of the constituency. So I hear in different, in one area I hear the same thing. Caymanian people are being forgotten. And then I hear in an affluent area, Caymanian people are being forgotten. So I think that that's kind of our tie that binds right now. So I think being first in your country, absolutely, and feeling like your country is working for your good and for the good of all the people, that I think is one of our really, really, really major issues that we need to concentrate on, getting back to that.
What about something that the Cayman Islands is doing right, and how would you continue that?
I think we've done right in a lot of areas. Tourism is one of them. I think we've opened our doors and we've welcomed many to our shores. We've built a lot financially. I think we've done well from the outskirts. So when you drive around the coast, you see the beauty of the island, but inland are where we see some of the issues. So I think that we're doing well from one standpoint, but we now have to incorporate the indigenous people, the Caymanian people, so that we feel that all of these good things that we see, the flourishing that we see, it's a part of us as a people, that we're actually experiencing that.
So if you're elected, day one, what's your top priority?
I tell you what, my top priority, the minute that I step into that legislative assembly, is to ensure that every single child that graduates high school knows how to read. We cannot put people in the working world, put people in the world, and they don't have the basics of survival. Because if you can't read or write, you don't have the basics of survival. You can't get a driver's license legally. You can't apply for a job. You can't work, basically. So what are you going to do? I think that has been a disservice that we've done to our people. So that's my day one. Right now, that's my day one.
Ms. Tyson, thank you for joining us. We think this has been a great opportunity for the people watching to learn more about you and your district. So thank you very much. And once again, this has been James Whittaker with the Cayman Compass. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.